In 1908, the most powerful explosion ever recorded struck Siberia, and scientists remain baffled. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to ring the bell for more. June 30th, 1908 started like any other day in Vannevara, Siberia. But then the earth shook, quite literally, in an explosion of unrivaled force. Indeed, the area had just been witness to one of the biggest scientific mysteries of our time, and it's one that continues to baffle the brightest minds even today. This incredible incident became known as the Tunguska event, so called because of the nearby stony Tunguska River. But what exactly was it? A meteor? A bomb? The only thing we really know is that this was the most powerful explosion of its type in recorded history. In fact, it's estimated that the blast had a force of up to 30 megatons of TNT. For the layman, that's equivalent to 1,000 atomic bombs the size of the one dropped on Hiroshima, Japan at the end of World War II. In this instance, though, it's thought that a huge fireball traveled through the sky on shockwaves, measuring 5.0 on the Richter scale. Furthermore, the downward force of the blast, which leveled some 80 million trees, spread over an area of 830 square miles. Needless to say, for the few who called this desolate part of Siberia home, the Tunguska event must have been the stuff of nightmares. And indeed, what few eyewitness accounts there are make for terrifying reading. For instance, one observer said that the sky was split in two, and that high above the forest, the whole northern part of the sky appeared covered with fire. A local deer herder, meanwhile, reportedly perished after the blast propelled him into a tree. Interestingly, the Tunguska event's shockwaves were felt as far away as the UK. Nevertheless, the Tsarist regime at the time had no real desire to investigate what had happened. In all fairness, though, it was probably more concerned with the potential revolution on the horizon. This meant, however, that two long decades passed before official investigators finally headed to the blast site. And even then, permission for the expedition was only granted after Leonid Kulik, a meteorite specialist, lobbied his bosses and persuaded them that the incident was worth looking into. Despite the passage of time, however, the huge areas of toppled trees made it seem as if the blast had literally just happened. Yet, if this was the work of a meteor, Kulik could find no sign of a crater. What's more, those living closest to the blast were hesitant to open up to Kulik and apparently believed that the explosion was the work of a vengeful god. The question remained then, could the mineralogist use his scientific expertise to work out what happened? Well, he was certainly going to try. Indeed, undeterred by the absence of a crater, Kulik put his mind to work. He even speculated that the swampy Siberian surface of the area had absorbed a meteorite and consumed any blown-off debris. Kulik's next theory, though, came approximately a decade later, long after his return. At this time, he thought it might be possible to find crushed masses of nickeliferous iron, individual pieces of which may have a weight of 100 or 200 metric tons. This, however, would mean digging down some 80 feet. Russian scientists who later visited the blast site concluded, though, that a meteor hadn't broken up here. Indeed, they claimed that it was the work of a comet. They argued that since comets are made of compacted ice, it would have melted after entering the Earth's atmosphere, leaving behind little trace. This explanation, which was backed up by an authoritative report, failed to stem the flow of alternative theories, however. Was the Tunguska event really the result of a colliding comet, or could something more outlandish have been responsible? For example, some reckoned a collision of antimatter and matter was responsible. Others, meanwhile, wondered whether an alien spacecraft, possibly searching for a fresh supply of water, had crash-landed. So in 2013, a team from Ukraine's National Academy of Sciences set to work, determined to get to the bottom of the mystery once and for all. They decided, though, to do what their predecessors hadn't, look at the previously collected samples at a microscopic level. Fascinatingly, the researchers found small quantities of lonsdaleite, a carbon mineral that forms when a structure harboring graphite, namely a meteor, enters our planet's atmosphere. This mineral's makeup isn't dissimilar to that of diamonds. So it goes without saying that lead researcher Viktor Kovaznitsia concluded that nothing paranormal had occurred at Tunguska. His conclusion, however, is by no means categorical, and there's one thing in particular upon which scientists cannot agree. Because meteor showers occur regularly and often go unnoticed, there's no conclusive evidence that the samples Kovnitsia and company studied were from the 1908 incident. No one can say for sure, then, whether the Tunguska event was the result of a meteor, a comet, or, as others have suggested, an asteroid. However, whatever this explosion was, Kovnitsia said mankind will be helpless in the event of something similar happening in the future. Let's hope, then, that Tunguska was a once-in-a-planetary-lifetime event.